The International Symposium on Melanoma and Other Cutaneous Malignancies is back for its 17th year on Saturday, February 6th of this year. Dr. Omid Hamid and I will be chairing this conference. In addition, there'll be 11 world-renowned oncology experts giving specific talks throughout the day on dermatologic malignancies.
Despite this conference transforming into a virtual interactive event, it will still continue to be engaging and fast-paced. You'll have the opportunity to interact with expert faculty as well as your peers and get your questions answered and improve your understanding in relation to these malignancies.
With the conference going completely virtual this year, Omid, in what ways are you prepared to share your key findings?
Well, Jeff, I've prepped by reviewing what has happened throughout the year. Even though the pandemic has shut down meetings, the meetings have all gone virtual, and the data in melanoma, immunotherapy, Merkel and squamous cell carcinomas, and others have become amazing. We've talked about and presented data in the adjuvant setting, in the metastatic setting, new combinations, the ability to understand and treat toxicity. And let's not forget, the data that we get from metastatic melanoma and adjuvant melanoma is used for the treatment and trials for almost every solid tumor these days. What are the most challenging clinical trials that will be presented this year, Jeff? How will this impact practices in the future?
Well, certainly we're going to hear about a number of trials. We'll hear about the INSPIRE 150 trial, which was a triple combination immunotherapy targeted therapy versus targeted therapy alone trial, which had a 16.1 month versus a 12.3 month median PFS difference favoring the triplet. That was atezo-vemcobi versus vemcobi alone. 3 months plus absolute difference in median survival, which led to a recent FDA approval. So that's potentially practice changing. We'll have a few negative trials. For example, the SWOG 1320 trial was a trial where people were looking at BRAF-MEK continuous versus intermittent based on some interesting mouse data. Absolute bust, no difference in survival. No one should be doing intermittent BRAF-MEK therapy, no question. We'll hear about the Ipi-Pembro-Olsen abstract from ASCO with a 27% response rate in patients who were PD-1 failures. So giving PD-1 CTLA-4 blockade clearly will generate some benefit with a fairly good median survival. So very impressive data. We'll hear about the phase 2 TIL trial that I think is going to lead to a registration sometime this year. It was the Iovance C144-01 cohort 2 trial, where there was about a 36% response rate with the median duration of response not reached, pretty good survivals, very impressive data in a completely PD-1 and or CTLA-4 refractory population. And then finally, we'll hear the updates from CheckMate 238 and Keynote-054, which at 4 and 3 years respectively, I think will encourage us that immunotherapy for adjuvant therapy for stage 3 disease and even stage 4 resected disease is here to stay. So what I'd like to ask you, Omid, is what advice do you have for the newer attendees to our meeting?
Jeff, I'd tell them to get ready to learn a lot in a short amount of time from people who really know what they're talking about. These are people that we work with who set the standards for the trials, who know how to manage patients. And given the fact that immunotherapy and even targeted therapy has taken over in multiple solid tumors, get ready to have your questions answered. Triple therapy, adjuvant therapy, toxicity, biomarkers, these are all hot topics that we will address, and we will address them in succinct ways where you leave the meeting knowing exactly how to take care of your patients. So, Jeff, what are some of the hot topics attendees can expect to learn about in this year's annual International Symposium on Melanoma and Other Cutaneous Malignancies?
Well, I think the biggest spotlight is probably going to be on Janice Taub's talk. She's an outstanding pathologist at Johns Hopkins. She's going to give us really a tour de force discussion of tumor biomarkers. I think we're going to hear a lot about neoadjuvant therapy. It's all the rage. It hasn't had its randomized trial yet, but I think it's certainly a very hot topic. we'll hear some negative trials, which will be practice influencing, you know, the disappointing negative results of Checkmate 915, suggesting that ipi-nivo probably doesn't have a place as adjuvant therapy, at least at the dose and schedule tested. And again, unfortunately, the negative COMBI trial, which was another triplet of a PD-1 BRAF-MEK combination versus BRAF-MEK, which makes you wonder what's going to be the place of triplet therapy in melanoma. So that's going to be a hot topic. We're going to have a lively discussion about that.
Well, stay tuned because there'll be a lot of discussion